Welcome back to the channel. So in this episode, I'm going to show you how you can extend the capabilities of the already awesome application Ulauncher. So let's jump into the computer and get started. Cool, so here we are in the computer and let's now download and install Ulauncher. So I'll do a search for Ulauncher in a web browser. And ulauncher.io is the page. And then I'll just jump straight to the downloads page. And so these are the install instructions for various operating systems. If you're using Ubuntu, then you could install using the PPA, and there are also Arch and Fedora install instructions. But I'm using MX Linux, which is of course a Debian-based system. So I'm going to download this deb package. So I'm going to download this to my downloads folder. Actually, no, I'll move this to my app installers. And this way, if I want to uninstall it, I actually have the deb package that will allow me to uninstall it as well. So I'll just save that. So I'll now double click the deb package to launch the GDB package installer. There we go. And I'll minimize Firefox for now. And then click install package. I'll open the terminal. And so this is a very quick install because it's a pretty small program. There you go, it's already done. So I'll close out a GDB package installer and then jump into my apps menu and then run Ulauncher. There it is there. Cool, so it's now running in my system. If I wanted to actually launch Ulauncher on my keyboard, I just press Control Space and there we go, Ulauncher has loaded. So I can quickly from here run applications like, for example, Time Shift. And there you go, because it's already selected, I can just press enter and that will run Time Shift or Firefox. And so right now Fire Tools is the application that is highlighted, so I just use my down arrow, or I could just keep typing and there you go, Firefox. So that's how easy it is to launch applications. And so let's jump into the Ulauncher preferences. So control space, and then this cog here will load the preferences, or you could actually load them from the system tray icon. Here are the preferences there. So first thing I'm gonna do is select launch at login. So every time I boot up my computer, Ulauncher will be running in the background. And the color theme, you can easily change this to a different color theme, elementary dark. So that's now a dark theme, but I'm actually going to download a theme to change the look so it suits my desktop theming. So I'll jump back into the web browser and then go back to the Ulauncher start page and then click on this color themes page. And then scroll down this list here and there are plenty of color themes you can choose from. I actually have one in mind, so I'll just keep scrolling till I find it. Here it is here, the Omni theme Ulauncher. And so this will actually go perfectly in line with the theming that I'm using for my desktop. So I'll click on that, scroll down this page here, and I'll give a shout out to these awesome contributors, especially Jeffrey Silver. Very, very cool color theme. Cool, so the install instructions can be found here, install.md, so I'll click that. And then I'll actually copy this code here. So I'll copy this from git clone onwards, and I'll just make sure not to select the dollar sign, and then open up a terminal window. Actually, I needed to copy that, didn't I? Control C to copy, and then go over to my terminal, Control Shift V to paste, and then enter. And this should be pretty quick to install. There we go, that's done. So I'll exit out of there. And I'll minimize Firefox. And so this won't actually show up just yet, so I'll close and reopen my preferences. And in the color theme now, the new theme has shown up, so I'll select that. And so now I actually have a cool color scheme. So this actually goes perfectly in line with my desktop environment. Cool, so that's the theming done. So what I'm going to do now is actually extend the capabilities of this awesome application. So I'll go to the extensions tab, and then to find extensions, just click on this discover extensions link. And this can also be found if you are on the Ulauncher website. Here is another link to the same page. So I'll go back to the browse extensions. And I'll close the other tabs. And so on this page are heaps of really awesome extensions. So I'm going to actually install a few extensions. The first one will be the YouTube searcher. So where is that? Actually, I'll just do a search for it. Control F to find, and then YouTube. There it is there, YouTube search. So I'll control click that, open it in a new tab, and then I'll do a search for emoji. There we go. And I'll control click that to open in a new tab. And so to actually install an application, I'll tile this window to the left. I'll go to the YouTube search page and copy this link here. And then go into the preferences for Ulauncher, click add extension, paste that link, and click add. And so this will take about a minute or so to actually install into Ulauncher. So I'll just wait for that minute. Oh, there it goes. It's actually loaded already. Cool. So I'll actually add another one, and I'll go to the emoji extension and then copy that link and then paste that here. And this will probably take about a minute or so to install. And let's see how we're going. I'll reload the list. No, it's still loading. So let's try reloading the list again. And there we go. The emoji extension has now been added. And now to actually use these extensions, all you have to do is type in the keyword. So for YouTube, it's YT. And for emoji, it's EM. So let's try the YouTube one first. So control space to load the Ulauncher, and then YT space, and then I'll search for MX Linux 21. And there you go, it's now loaded the page. And oh, look, here's my video here, by the way. So if you're interested in setting up and customizing MX Linux, then please jump into my channel and there is plenty of info in there. Or if you want to use the emoji extension, then you just type in EM space, and then you can actually do a search for an emoji. So for example, rolls on the floor laughing, then you just click it and then go on to your web page that you want to paste it to and paste it like so. And it's that easy. So you don't have to actually go searching online for emojis. You can just quickly use Ulauncher to find emojis. And this works with multiple emojis. So let's say EM penguin, and then paste, and it's that simple. And now a quick word from our sponsor, which is Stæmpunk TV. So please, if you'd like to help out the channel, jump into the comments, leave us a comment, or subscribe and like the video, and that really, really helps the channel out. I'm aiming to get 1,000 subscribers in the next couple of months, or maybe even quicker, and so I could definitely do with your assistance. So thanks for tuning in, and let's get back to the video. So that's a couple of extensions now extending the ability of Ulauncher. Now I'll move over to the shortcuts page. And so Ulauncher actually comes with these three shortcuts already pre-installed. So for example, if you wanted to search wiki, you just load Ulauncher and then type in wiki, and then you can actually do a search for anything that you want to search for. So for example, let's do a search for YouTube. And that pulls up the Wikipedia page for YouTube. So that's very, very cool. But let's actually add a few more shortcuts. So to do that, just jump into your web browser, and I'll open a new tab and close the other ones. And then the first shortcut that I'm going to create is to be able to search for icons. So a really cool website is icon-icons.com. And so what I want to do is actually find the search URL. So I'll just do a search for DuckDuckGo. There we go. And so what I'll do is I'll copy this URL, Control C, and then jump into the preferences, click add shortcut, and then paste into this field here. And because I'm searching for DuckDuckGo, I'll delete that. and replace it with this placeholder percentage S. So percentage S, and then I'll give it a name. So that is of course icon hyphen icons. And then the keyword to launch this icon search will be icon. And then for the shortcuts icon, I'll actually go to the icon icons website and then just right click their icon here, save image as, and I'll save this to my icons folder that I made in my earlier video. So I'll just save that. Now, as you may have noticed, it was actually an SVG file, which is perfectly fine. Ulauncher will recognize SVG files, JPEGs, or even PNGs. I'm not actually sure if it works with WebEms as well, but if you do know, then just let me know in the comments. Cool, so that's now downloaded. So I'll now go back to the preferences, click to select icon, and then I'll click on the icon icons SVG and click open. That's now loaded. I can save that. So that's my first shortcut. The second shortcut, while this is open anyway, will actually be for DuckDuckGo. So I'll click add shortcut and then I'll jump into my web browser, open a new tab. And because DuckDuckGo is my default search engine, I'll just do a search for, say, neon. Cool, and then I'll copy the URL and then jump into my preferences, add that to the query or script. And so all I want to do is delete everything after this equals and replace that with percentage S. And then I'll name it, which is DuckDuckGo. And the keyword that will launch this will be DDG. And I actually want to download the logo now, so I'll click on one of these. And let's see, I just want the 64 pixels version, so that's big enough. Download that. And then save to my icons directory. Cool, then back in preferences, click to select icon and DuckDuckGo. Then I'll actually make this the default search and save. And because this is now the default search, I'll make sure that these other ones are not the default search. So I'll just deselect each of these. Cool, and I'll actually install one more, which will be for freepik.com. So I'll go back to my web browser and then open up freepik.com. And here we are at Freepik, so I'll close the icon icons page. And I'll maximize this window and just do a search for neon. And I actually want to search the free resources, so I'll just select that. Cool, so with all that done, I'll now copy this URL. And I'll tile that back to half screen. And then back in the Ulauncher preferences, click add shortcut and then paste into the query or script. And then replace the word neon, which is what I was searching for, with percentage S. So I'll leave everything after that intact because I'm assuming selection one refers to the free resources. Cool, so then for the name, I'll call this Free resources. And then for the keyword, I'll use FP. And now I just need the icon, so I'll go back here. And I can actually do a search for icons. And let's do a search for Freepik. Ah, here we go. So here are the Freepik icons, but actually I want the blue one here because I think that looks nicer. So let's see if I can right click that. No, that won't let me save that. So I'll open a new tab and just search for Freepik icon PNG. There it goes. And I want the PNG because it's more likely to have a transparent background. So let's go to the images page and let's see. This one here is pretty cool. 800 by 600 is a bit smaller than that massive one. And as you can see here with the checkerboards, that means that this is a transparent background. So I'll go view file and then right click, save image as, and that goes into my icons folder as well. Cool. And then back in preferences, I'll load that free pick logo and then save, and that is done. So now these are the shortcuts that I have to remember: FP for free pick, DDG for DuckDuckGo, and icon for icons, wiki for Wikipedia, SO for Stack Overflow, and G for Google search. So let's try this out. I'll open a new tab and I'll close all the other ones. And I'll close the preferences and then load my Ulauncher and then type in FP space and now do a search for Penguin. And there we go. It's now searched the free resources for Penguin on the FreePick website. So that is how awesome Ulauncher is. So I hope this helped you speed up your workflow, and I'll catch you in the next video.